You that I do not believe that this battle that we are in is ultimately about budgets or even ultimately about the economy and jobs, as important as those things are, and they are important. They are urgent matters. But I believe there's something deeper going on, and what is deeper is the fact that there is the rise of a new vision of who we are as Americans and who our country is supposed to be and what our future is. I don't agree with this new vision. We are not a socialist country. We are a free nation of individuals. This battle is about freedom, freedom, freedom. I know that they think that they can intimidate us and they can make us fall down to their will, but it's about time we send a message to Washington, and you all standing up lets me know that you want to send it too. We don't work for you, you work for us. And I want to encourage you. We're going to win this battle. We're going to win it because we believe in freedom. We're going to win it because we believe that we are a nation of laws and not of men, and the whims of the White House and an attorney general don't rule over us. Our Constitution rules over us. Our laws rule over us, not these individuals. We're going to win because we are not a balkanized nation of black against white, against brown, against yellow, men against women, rich against poor. We're going to win because we believe that we are one America, and if we stand together and fight together, we can overcome anything, and we are tired of people trying to divide us. We need to send a message to Washington that you are not going to divide us. Mr. President, we don't have a problem with whether you're black or not. We have a problem with whether you're red, white, and blue. We're going to win because we still hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal and endowed by our Creator with certain inalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. In other words, my friends, they need to be reminded the government didn't give us our rights. God did, and we're not going to lay down and let the government take our rights away. So I will just leave you with this in the short time I had. I don't have time to deal with the individual issues, but I want to tell you that the Liberty Bell that hangs in Independence Hall is silent. It was cracked for the last time in 1846 on George Washington's birthday, but liberty was never meant to ring in a bell. Liberty rings in our hearts. And my friends, it's time to let it ring again. My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land of my father's pride, land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside let freedom ring. It's time to let it ring again. It's time to answer the question that Ben Franklin left us when he told Mrs. Powell, we've given you a republic if you can keep it. It's time to let Washington know, let the White House know, let the Congress know, we have a free republic. It is a constitution. Republic of limited government, and by the grace of Almighty God, we are going to keep it. God bless you.